There's a lot of people that are sick and afflicted across our world, and I have compassion for them. And we have some right here in our local church, and we can call name upon name. That's really not my intent right now. But I think all of us know the serious, very serious cases among us. And if not, pause and look at the board there a moment. Screen before you, and you can see those that are, some of them in nursing homes, some afflicted, some not able to walk well, some in need of prayer, for many others, and their names not on there, that need God. And some of them are here in our church, which swell our congregation even beyond the good attendance we have if we had those people on the firing line. We're going to pray tonight, and also if you have need of special prayer, I'm going to call the elders to stand with me, and if you're an elder, a man of God, you can always come at this time of the service and stand with us in prayer. And anyone that's here tonight and needs the oil of anointing upon them, and you need God to help you, let the elders pray with you. Let the elders pray in the name of the Lord. If there be any sick among you, let them call for the elders of the church. And let them pray anointing the Lord. In the name of the Lord, and the Lord shall save the sick. And the prayer of faith shall lead them up. So tonight, we're going to obey God's word. And if there's one of you that needs a special touch in your body, make your way here. If you can't get here, lift your hand. Let someone know. No Brother Westbury, I know personally he has been suffering, but God is able. Brother Westbury, really one of our elders of the church. He loves the Lord. All right, elders, we're going to praise the name of the Lord. Amen. 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 Go down where you can be with him. Bounding, praise the name of the Lord. The surrounding with oil. The surrounding with oil. Praise God. Amen. 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 Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God.
Praise the Lamb of God.
Praise the Lamb of God.
Thank you. Our song. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Lord, to receive our Saturday night offering. We pray that God will sanctify this offering I give to you. We're in much all the Christmas season. We have to make decisions about what we do with our tithing offering at this time of year. Mine will not go to a department store.
Nor will ours.
It cannot belong there.
Praise the Lord.
I will go to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
That's where it belongs. I sanctify it, I set it apart. See, I believe giving is an act of worship. I don't believe give because someone forces you to. I don't believe giving. I'm not careless in my giving. Every week, just as surely as I come to church, I set apart this. Four times a week. I sanctify it. I set it apart. It does not go to any other place. It goes to the house of God. Praise God. May God bless you tonight as you worship Him and give Him. And if it's the widow's mite and that's what God is giving you, then give that abundantly and cheerfully. But if God has blessed you more, then give more. And God will bless you more. Not in monetary value necessarily. That does come. That does happen. But He will bless you in so many other ways. My life has been so blessed.
My life.
Oh, my.
So blessed. Hey.
All my life, Jesus has given to me. All my life, He's let His people give. God is so good. God is so good. Praise His name. So if you've been in our church, I know you're used to ushers coming and getting your offering, and we do that. We're not informed. We'll change it up, and sometimes we'll just have the brethren come and see your offering. But tonight, we'll just come to the offering box. We'll give us, God give to us. May God bless you as you give tonight. Praise the name of the Lord.
Thank you.
am lifting up in my spirits. I hope you are, because God is good. These songs we've been singing, they just tell the story of we that are Christians. Because I do have a roof over my head. I do have shoes on my feet. I do have food on my table. And I have a good place to sleep. And even had a new dog get into the family this week. So now we have Teddy that lives in our house. And Lily just fell in love with him, and they're getting along well. Teddy and Lily. She's the boss. She'll know that. The moment he came in the door, and he's a great Pyrenees. Just a teddy bear. And God makes wonderful creations in what we call dogs. Reverse dog, D-O-G, and it spells D-O-D. There must be something in that that God arranged in the language. But we are glad to greet you, and I want to take a moment to, we're fast running out of the year, and we have, tonight is the 19th, we have 12 more days in this year, and we'll be into 2016. And I would like to greet you, and I'll do it again, possibly a couple more times as we go through the holiday season, but I'd like to say to each one, say it several times, as your pastor, completing my 55th year of pastoring this work. We came here in December, 55 years ago. We just a young couple starting out in the extension of ministry. I had pastored, let me see how many churches I had pastored before I came back here after being discharged from Fort Sill, Oklahoma, United States Army, in December. Come back from overseas after 13 months of journey. And I came back to this country and finished my time up. And we shone with the Lord in dreams in Germany. Two consecutive dreams there back in the Army liturgy, guard duty, sleeping after my time came to rest a little while. Wunschfeld, Germany, way up in near the Bavarian border and the snowfields. And we was lying there and I went to sleep. And God gave me the dream of this city and being locked up in prison. A jail cell, an open cell, down to the square of Bradenton. There was a young man, a person in Bradenton. I held the bars and I greeted at first, God, let me out. I did not want to be in the sea of Bradenton. I knew it was a city of sorrows. I was a young man. And my memories were not good of the city. But God, in a dream, a voice said, you're not going to get out. You're going to do my work that calls you to do this. I won't release you for many years. And then I began to change and grow older in the dream and gray my hair. And I was holding the bars. And some people came by, some of them I knew. I was reared here in this church as a young man. And so I knew some of them, and some of them slapped at me and slapped my hands and mimicked me and mocked me. They would act rude and bad toward me. Some cursed me in the dream. And some would come by and they would, Brother Marlowe, here's a piece of bread. Hold on. Here's a little cup of water. Hold on. Do what God should do. And in the dream, a voice said, you do what I want you to do. I developed a church while I was overseas 13 months. Every week I wrote a letter. There was around 50 saints that left the church that I pastored in Anna, Illinois in 1958 when I resigned, and God showed me to move out of that movement and out front of the covering of a certain bishop, and the Lord said, he isn't going the right direction, and you can't follow him. And I resigned the church, gave it up. He said, how long will it take you to leave the church? I said, give me a week, and I'll be out. He said, are you going to divide the church when you leave? And I said, no. Last night in there, I'm going to preach with all my heart, keep souls saved. I will never mention our differences, but you will divide the church. I said, I can no longer follow a man that is following God. And he said, then clear the parsonage and get out. And so my youngest brother, David Marlowe, that runs Marlowe Marine, I'd taken him in. He had no home. And I was rearing David. And he was going to school. And the Lord said, when the Lord spoke to me and said, go down the stairs of the city that the bishop was in, the Lord said, I will take care of you. I will take care of you. His last words to me was, you'll never preach again. I'll make your name mud across the United States. Well, he did that all right. He fulfilled that promise. But God was good to me. I just told him, I said, may the Lord bless you real good. I'm going on to do what God would have me do. And the Army is calling. I'll be there for 2 years at least. I'll find God's will. Well, when we, Sister Marlowe and I married shortly after that, after 6 months, I came to Florida and I copied a favorite apostle of mine, Peter. I went fishing. Peter said, I'm going fishing. And my father was a fisherman, my brother's a fisherman, so I went mullet fishing and I cleared my head. And you know, we criticized Peter a lot, but you know, Peter was in the will of God.
Yes.
Though he backslid and denied Jesus, but Peter was in the will of God because Peter needed to clear his head.
Yes.
He needed to find the will of God.
Yes.
And he did find it on that sea that he went back to. And he found the will of God. He found a trial can turn into a blessing.
Yes.
A purging can lead you back to God.
Yes.
A chastening can direct your attention back to God. It isn't always a curse. A chastening is not always a curse.
Amen.
Sometimes it's a blessing. When the Lord chastens, whom the Lord loveth, he chastens. And so it's with every son that he received. You be without chastisement. If you be without it, then you are an illegitimate child and not a son before God. But when that took place, we went then to Germany after basic training, married Sister Marlowe and I, and in Germany. And was there 13 months and came back to this country. But in that time, 50 of the people from that church that lived in other vicinities, 20 miles around the church, began to write me and ask me for Bible lessons and to explain scriptures. And they had no pastor. They had left that church. And Southern Illinois. I mean, write them every week. I'd sit down and write a letter back to the saints in Vienna, Illinois. And when I would write, the Lord would quicken me. And I would write lessons on the scriptures and explain those scriptures to them every week. And then I made tape recordings and sent them back every week. I was there in Germany. And the Lord let me minister there in Germany, led a captain to the Lord, cursing an army captain that was a veteran of Korea. I led him to the Lord. He came to Christ. He invited me to his quarters. And he told me, this is the Army protocol. And the Army officers do not associate with enlisted men.
No.
That's against Army protocol. And he said, I'm breaking the rule. You come and sit with my family and explain to me what you have that I don't have. And I said, all right. His wife picks up her, his two children was there that night with him, and his quarters, officer's quarters. And the Lord sat down and explained salvation to this man who was a vile sinner. Cursed the truth, hard on the truth. But God, when we finished talking, he said, can we pray? And we got down around the table, the family and I, and that captain with the two silver bars on his shoulder gave his life to Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord.
Found Jesus as his Savior and Lord. He resigned his commission in the Army, came back to this country to study to be a minister. And somewhere in this country, he's ministering now. He's still living. That's just one of the experiences God gave me. At prayer meetings in the arms room, this is a platoon, members of the platoon, read the Bible. You know, many times we ration God to a place called a church house. God is everywhere. God is omnipotent. He's omnipresent. I said, God is everywhere. We ration him to the church house. We do that. He doesn't do that. God is a God that's everywhere. And but we ration him to the church. But our mission is to a lost and dying world. Not just in the confines of scheduled services of worship in a church. But our mission is to reach a lost and dying world. Praise the name of the Lord. Be ready to preach Christ. Everywhere. Anywhere. Only wonder if I had many experiences, but when I began to develop the church, lo and behold, God began to bless the church in Nevada, Illinois, and the Holy Ghost in the United States. They write me letters. And they leased a building, and they thought I was coming back to be their pastor there. And that's where I would have gone, in the natural. They had a big banner up, tomorrow, welcome home, sir, tomorrow, fixed a dinner for us. But I walked in and I said, I'm sorry. God has not called me here. He's called me to a city far south. City that I was reared up in, I had to leave. And left one of the elders in charge and came here. They were with here, two 27-year-old people starting out to do God's will, trying to find his will, wanting to carry out his will. And got out of our car the night that we drove up, and they put us in the little apartment. Those walls there, and came out and walked around the building. The building was only over here then. This was some trees planted here, and we walked. There was a sandy road out front there, fence. No cars to park over there. You're parking now. This was woods back here, this is where we came. There was a super sandy. Her family had just come into the church here. And I had prayed that God would send a family in because it was a very small congregation. A larger congregation was in Southern Illinois. The better prospect to the eye was Southern Illinois. But God said, come here. This was the place. And when we came up, my sister Sandy back here, Elsenheimer, she's a cousin of mine, kinship. Her family had just come into the church, and they were here, and they were musicians, and the children, they all played instruments, And that was a sign. The Lord came in, and we walked up and they greeted us. They called me Uncle, and we were their cousin. You always call me. So Uncle John, we are coming to the church here now. We got saved. I said, well, Lord, this is a sign. Thank you, Lord. God is good, isn't he? To lead us
all the time.
So after 55 years, we're still here by the grace of God. We're still here by his will. And you are here, and we love you. So tomorrow and I have never ceased to love the church through these years. Many times highs, many times some lows. But we won't talk about lows. We'll talk about the highs. I'm high tonight. Praise God. I'm looking forward to the most explosive, dynamic, growth year of the Holy Ghost in Bradenton. I'm looking forward to the church being activated, alive, well, vibrant, strong, of God's goodness flowing like a river. I'm looking forward to new families coming, new people being added. I'm looking forward to all of you gracious, wonderful families that have been added recently. The Lord's been adding families, adding to us. You were not here last year, this time last year. Brother Dale, Sister Joan, I'm so thankful for you.
Yes.
You were so glad you came. You don't know what you're going to do.
Amen.
We really love you. We really do. No put on, no pretense. We just do. You're godly people. You love the Lord. Your lives are clean before God. And I appreciate that. And I appreciate that in this church.
Amen.
Brother Butch is still not a great blessing.
Amen.
What an encouraging
God
for the remnant of such a faith. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Well, Raymond was a boy here. This was also a city of sorrows for him. He grew up in a rough fashion. But God said, come back.
And
every time they tried to go away, he'd say, come back. Every time they tried to get away, God said, come back. Praise the Lord. It must be he wants you here. He is will. We're going to be here. And then recently we had Sister Charlotte come and Natalie. Charlotte, it's really good to have you.
Yes.
Natalie. Yes.
And I'm glad the Lord chose to send you to Bradenton.
Amen.
You've been a friend of Bradenton since you were about. You came here as a young woman. But your husband wouldn't let you stay. You lived on the grounds. And here. But you're here to stay now,
Charlotte.
Yes. And God wants you back to stay. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. 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 Because Brother Darrell's been sick this week. And so many, many others God has added. And I appreciate Brother Don House, Sister Gloria.
Yes.
I've known them many years. We've known each other many years. Recently, Gloria and John, the Lord has been saying to me, I'm going to do something this time. I'm going to let the work and the work God's given you to do bond together. Mm-hmm. And there's a future for us in the Lord.
Yes.
There's a future.
Thank you, Lord.
For a ministry in the Lord. Because this church is not a closed in, sealed house of an organized body that will judge after the flesh, not after the spirit. This place is free.
Amen.
We're free tonight.
Amen.
We are not denominated with any stamp that man would put upon us.
Yes.
We are free to follow the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, and let the power of God lead your hands.
Let's
give the Lord a clap. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So I'm envisioning Gloria's written a book. We'll have it for your consumption. We'll have several copies of it. And we're getting our library fixed up back here and painting back there and our bookstore. And next week, it should be ready. And we'll have books in there for you to read at home with you if you wish. And godly books, good books, to inspire you, help you, and if you choose to read them, and a selection of them, and then we'll have the Sister Gloria written. She's writing another one now, and she'll be finished yet. We'll have a copy of her book, The Story of Her Life, and angels ministered to her, visiting her, guiding, leading. It's an interesting book. I've read it and endorse it to be a book that encourages God's family. We'll have that available. Got an exciting week coming up. I'll give you a little resume. Tomorrow we'll have dinner in the dining room, our Christmas dinner. And then we'll be going into the week, Christmas week. I do not worship a Christmas tree. I do not worship anything that has been added to the Christmas season that is pagan or not of the scriptures. But I do worship the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
I celebrate him. I am glad that the world is speaking about his birth right now.
Yes.
Even as wicked as we live in, the world we live in, did you know every time about this season, you can feel a difference. As wicked as the world is, as much sin as there is, as much trouble as there is, but you can feel a difference in the atmosphere. That's because Jesus is mentioned.
Yes.
Now, they may mention how the merchants may advertise something about Christmas to sell their goods. I'm not going to be bitter, angry at them for doing that. They're merchants. But I don't do that. I don't sell Jesus. I don't use the season to have actors on the stage or pretenders on the stage. There was a real Joseph.
Yes.
He doesn't need an actor on the stage. There was a real Joseph.
There was
a real Mary. There was a virgin. Holy night, solid night, was there that night. Thank God for the song that speaks of it. We don't need the character cut out. We just worship Jesus, and we thank God for the people that betrayed the family of Jesus, Joseph. Mary, manger sin brings humility to me. I feel humble when I think of a king bleeding and dying for me.
Yeah.
Lying in a manger, I've never slept in a manger. I've never known the humiliation he did. I've never had spittle on my face, or the spear in my side, or the nails in my hand. But he did. He did. From the manger to the cross. What is that song? From the manger to the cross. From the cross to the grave.
From the grave to the sky.
From the grave to the sky. Let's say that again. Matthew, say that again.
Came from heaven to earth. Came from heaven to earth. So away from the earth to the cross. To the cross to the grave.
Lord, I lift your name.
Praise the Lord.
Well, I'm going to praise him again.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I don't think we can praise him too much.
Praise your name.
I'm reminiscing them for you and giving you a little atmosphere of the Christmas time. We can't praise him enough. Praise the name of the Lord. Lord, we lift your name on high. From the grave to the sky. From the manger to the cross, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, we lift your name on high. Oh, church tonight, Let's have a Pentecostal moment here. Let's praise him, brother. Christmas, and I was speaking to the school children here Friday in our chapel service, our school, Christian school, and I said, when you spell Christmas, do not make the mistake of putting X in a S. Don't do that.
No.
I don't spell Christmas that way.
No.
It's not Xmas.
No.
It will never be Xmas.
No.
It's C-H-R. IST, Christ body, Christmas, must body, Christ body, he's the one, he's the one, not XMAS, CHRIST. I'm glad I know how to spell his name. Praise the name of the Lord. So we're going to worship him during this Christmas time. We don't embrace any of the, we don't believe that the giving of presents is in the scriptures. We don't believe giving is in the scriptures. If you give a present, give in the right spirit, give a joy, joyful heart, then you're being biblical because you're loving. And God is love. There are many things that added to Christmas. We're bypassing all of that. We're just glad we can worship the Savior.
Amen.
Christ the Savior.
Praise God.
For he was born this day in the city of David. The angels cried, holy, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Oh, Joseph, Joseph, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which has been conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord. I worship his name tonight. I embrace his name tonight. And he's a day star. And for a brief moment, I won't keep you long. I want this night to be a night of praise. I want you to worship him. I want you to pray for the sick. I want you to get ready for a tremendous week next week. We'll be having service here Wednesday night, right on through the week. Next week will be a week of Bible study, Monday night, and we're putting off the convention meeting after Christmas. And it will be convention meetings from then on to the convention, Monday night after Christmas. But we'll have Bible study this week, Monday night. Tuesday night will be for bilingual, and then Wednesday night we'll have a wonderful night of worship and memory unto the Lord, praise unto the Lord, just before Christmas Eve and the Christmas Day. Then we'll be back here for the weekend as normal, and I believe Brother Stewart will be in Fort Charlotte Christmas Eve on that Thursday night. So that I haven't talked to you. Are you having, Brother Stewart, you having service there on all right Christmas Eve? Just want to let you all know where we're going, what we're doing next week. And if there's anyone that you know about, a family that's in need and they have nothing or they have little, and they're in the church or they're out of church, please let us know, because we will not go through that day and see someone lonely without the necessary food, the necessary thing to cheer them up on Christmas Day. Give us their name, give us their address, and let us know, and we'll be sure that they get food for that day, and they'll get some comfort. So I'm going to depend on the congregation. If there's anyone among us, and anyone I know, I certainly will get pastor taking care of that, the elders with me. But if you know anybody that is going to be afraid by themselves, lonely, feeling blue, sad, and you know they need cheering up, need prayer, you need help. Let it be known, whether it's in our church or outside, that we can give help to someone around us as we approach this Christmas day. Let's look forward to the Lord helping us for the wonderful, wonderful year ahead. Immediately after we start the new year, and on New Year's night, I'd like to talk to the church about the plans we have, starting with our convention in February, if people are coming. I talked to the Wilkes, in Georgia. In Georgia this last week, planning to come. I talked with Doug Atkins in Kingsport, Tennessee, planning to come. There's people coming for our meeting. We'll get ready for them, and we'll be sprucing the place up. We'll appreciate anybody and everybody on every Saturday. That will be work day after the New Year's. It'll be a work day here at the church getting ready for the convention. Every Saturday up until February the 11th, the convention comes. And I hope to get that into your heart and in your mind. And everybody can help. There's cleaning, there's brush up work to be done, and most anybody can be of help. And just an hour or 30 minutes, however much time you can give, let's get the place ready and refresh for the convention coming up. New Year's night, I'd like to talk to you about ministry and the drumbeat of the church for 2016. I'm all for changing. Sometimes when the drumbeat needs to be changed, the church grows when you change the drumbeat, when you stand on your watch. And everybody is vigilant. Everybody is ready. And everybody is in their place. I can't help it. I was trained to be a soldier. I know how to stop too. But I have to go about base. I understand those movements. I have a salute and an attention. I can't. I want the church to know that the church, that's all you young people down on that road. That's every one of you. Sister Sheena, that's you. Yeah. Jane, that's you. Thank God the Billings family. Praise the name of the Lord. They filled that front seat. And then right over in the second. Praise God. I'd say thank God for that. But you got a place. Every infant, every child has a place. Every man, every woman has a place. The church, if we change the drumbeat at the proper time, according to God's word, to the will of the Holy Ghost, this church will never die. I've watched it. I've watched it for 55 years. I've watched God sometimes let it down to a little flickering flame. It looked like it might go out. All of a sudden, Holy Ghost gasoline is poured on it. Praise God. And we started having revivals. Praise God. The fire sprang out. And the bruised reed wasn't broken. And the smoking flax wasn't quenched. And God would send help from the north, for the south, for east, for west. I watched that. Yes. Praise the name of the Lord. A few years ago, when we needed a witness that God was with us in this church, the power of God was falling here. The glory of God, I believe it was on Wednesday night. I'm not sure. You that were here possibly remember the night. Could have been a Saturday night. The power of God was so great in this place. People were falling and reeling and rocking under the power and down under the chairs and on the seats and sprawled out on the floor. We were holy rulers. My goodness. Power of God coming in here sweeping in this place. Was it the late 70s or the early 80s? I'm trying to remember now. Anyway, all of a sudden on that back wall back there, right back there, we had just enlarged the church. Just enlarged it. And it was paneled, wood paneled then. And all of a sudden, a flaming, burning cross was right there where you're sitting, child. Right there where your head is. there was a burning cross as visible as that screen is. And someone said, Brother Marla, look, the wall's on fire back there. The wall's on fire. I guess that's what they did about the burning bush, didn't they?
Yes.
I guess somebody said, the bush is on fire. Look, Moses, the bush is on fire. Oh, I love it when the bush gets on fire.
Yeah.
Don't you?
Yes.
Hey, but don't you love it when there's burning bush? Don't you love it when you can say, glory to God. There's a fire in here tonight. There's a blaze burning. The Holy Ghost is working. The Holy Ghost is moving. Praise the name of the Lord. The Holy Ghost is working. The Holy Ghost is moving. I'm going to say that again. I'm going to pour some gasoline on here. Amen. The Holy Ghost is moving. There's a fire in the face. You sit up. You pay attention. We're talking to those people across church. Pray the name of the Lord. Amen. You look and say, I got to get my mind on God.
Yes.
Get my mind on what the Lord is saying and doing. Yes. Praise God. There's a fire in the house.
Yes.
Somebody shouts, fire.
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 You know what they do when they shout fire? Brother, you better talk about people moving. They start moving when you shout fire. Fire. Well, it's coming for to be. That night, the Holy Ghost felt it never went out. It never went out. Went back to it, you could see it, but you couldn't touch it. On the wall, someone said, it didn't happen. You must have had a bad dream.
Oh, no.
I had a bad dream, some others did too. Several, the church was quite populous that time, and the power of God was falling so great until they went out on the parking lot.
Yeah.
And they were collapsing on the parking lot. Falling in the parking lot, couldn't get in their cars, and they're lying beside their cars. Praise the name of the Lord. God is great. God is good. God is great. God is good all the time, and He never, never is away from your need. And right here tonight, He's going to meet needs in this house, and people are going to go home a different way than they came. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let's go. For the drum beat to change. Praise the name of the Lord. We'll be talking, or I want to run over about four scriptures with you on the day star. And I'm going to end my little time of gathering the saints together. In the book of Matthew, the Bible said, and I love this, in describing Christ as the star of the east. In the first, I believe it's the second chapter of Matthew, that we have this description, and we'll get here in a minute. We'll get these pages turned loose. Chapter 2, this is at the birth of Jesus. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we've seen his star in the east, and have come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for that it is written by the prophet, and thou, Bethlehem, is the land of Judea, are not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had carefully called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search diligently for the young child. And when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him. Oh, God is smarter than any king ever was. He wasn't going to worship him. He was going to slay him. He was jealous. He knew that king would take his place. And he wasn't going to worship him. Oh, God had the wise men, and they, when they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
The star of the east.
Amen.
The star, the day star. Now go to 1 Peter 7:1-17, I believe it is. Your first or second, I'll get it in a moment. But here in the epistle of Peter, that Peter speaks of this day star and gives us enlightening on it. Yes, it's 2 Peter 1:19. Chapter 1, verse 19, 2 Peter. We have also a more sure word of prophecy. For unto you do well, and you take heed. I thank God for a sure word of prophecy. I'm glad our word is not fickle, it's not flighty. I'm glad the word is solid. It's a rock we stand upon. The rock of the Word of God.
Amen.
We have also a more sure word of prophecy, for unto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shineth in a dark place. Isn't it so tonight? The light that shines in the dark place. Until the day dawn and a day star arise in your hearts. I'm glad that we have found our day star. You know the reason that I call him the day star? He's not just a star of the east.
That's it.
And he's not just a star of the night. He's the day star.
Yes.
I see him in the day
yes.
as well as in my night. Have you seen the day star that's in the skies above us in the atmosphere in the early morning hour?
Yes.
Still there?
Yes.
Have you watched the day star?
Yes.
How many of you have seen the day star? Have you seen the day star? And though it was daytime, the star was still there. I thank God that through the night of man, the star has been shining. In my day, in my vision, in my time, when I'm a Christian, rejoicing, full of the knowledge of the Word, full of the knowledge of God as can be, full of the Holy Ghost, in a world that is going different ways and different matters and different majors. I tonight not only have seen the star of the east, I've seen the day star.
Amen.
And he's shining today.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes.
You know, there's a quality about a star. Now, go back over to the Old Testament. Go way back over the book of Numbers, the 24th chapter. I'm going to go backward, and then not only in the New Testament, is there a witness of the day star? There was a witness in the Old Testament as well. The quality of a star, we know that it's made up of gases. And those gases burn with a heat. And it's luminous. And again, that's what gives it its twinkling and shining in the night. Those gases burning in that creation of God. And it's luminous and can be seen the millions of miles and millions of miles of space. I don't know where old starlight goes. I just know that I see it. I'm glad he reserved some of it for me.
Amen.
I didn't put it all beyond Pluto and Mars if it is there. In fact, I don't think it's there because they've explored and they say that space is dark. The higher you go, space is dark. Our space isn't dark. Isn't God good to us?
Amen.
God, let the starlight be for us. I believe God created the distance of the stars, created the stars, whether they be miniature planets or whatever they are solid gas masses, burning, luminous for us to see. It's the creation of my God to bless me. Not only in the natural, because I love starlight night, don't you? I love the beautiful starlight night. I stand there and thank the wonder of God in that sky above me. I also love the spiritual star, that the day star is Christ, my Lord and Savior. He's the day star. He shines above all other stars. And we know, according to the scripture, we're going to touch one or two here before I cease in a few minutes. We also know that we're like an under stars. Because if we shine
in our testimony of what Christ has done for us in our salvation and our walk with God, if we really are possessors and not professors, if we really live and walk with Christ, and He lives and walks with us, and if we're really as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God, if we really are that, we're not a dark object wandering through our space of our society. I'm alive. I got the attention of the judge in the courtroom. And it's not because he wanted to hang me or hang me either this last week. He had no charge against me. But he just said from the bench, "Who is that gentleman back there?" Well, thank God, I'm glad he didn't say, "Come up here for your citizen." That would have been a sad moment. The judge looked back and said, "Who is that gentleman back there?" I must have had enough starlight. Someone said, "I'm nobody." You're a star.
Amen.
You're shining in the heavens.
You are somebody.
Somebody said, I always wanted to be a star. Come and be saved. Be regenerated.
Amen.
Be washed.
Amen.
Be cleansed. Be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Get a hold of God's hand. Walk with God. And you'll be a star.
Be a
praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Shining in the heavens, twinkling in the night. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So in the book of Numbers, chapter 24, the prophet said, verse 17, 24, chapter 24, verse 17, "I shall see him." Thank God the prophet said, "I shall see him," but I have seen him. The difference in the prophet and me is I have seen him. And I'm going to see him.
Amen.
Amen.
I have seen him, and I'm going to see him.
Yes.
Have you seen Jesus? Brother, yes, I have.
Amen.
You know, I can describe him to you. He's a rose. He's Rose of Sharon. He's the lily of the valley. He's the bright and morning star. He's my Savior. He's lovely. Altogether lovely. Can you describe Jesus? Are you acquainted with him? Job said, "Acquaint now thyself with him and be at peace." Thereby good shall come. But Job, I have. In the past, he said, "Acquaint now thyself." I have. I've acquainted myself. I know him very well. I know him so well that right now, when I get sick, I can say, "Jesus, please, you know, please deliver me." When I'm lonely, I can feel him in my house.
Amen.
When I need a friend, he's there.
Amen.
When I feel forsaken, he tells me I'm not.
Yes.
When I feel down, he lifts me up.
Yes.
When I have no hope, he gives me hope.
Yes.
I'm well acquainted with him.
Yes.
I see him. But the prophet said, "I shall see him, but not now. I shall behold him, but not now. There shall come a star out of Jacob. The day star. The day star. And a scepter shall rise out of Israel and shall smite the corners of Moab and destroy all the children of Seth." Now, hold your finger right there if you want to, or just keep in memory, and in memory, or go back there either way. I want to correlate that scripture with Peter that I just read. Again, I want to just bring those two together. Verse 19, chapter 1, 2 of Peter. "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, wherein to you would do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shineth in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star arise in your heart." Well, the day star has arisen in my heart and yours. That's the reason this church gets rather noisy sometimes. That's the reason they call us the Holy Ghost Church, our Pentecostal people. We praise him. We glorify him.
Yes.
And I do.
Yes.
My vocal cords spring into action when I walk into the church. Praise God.
Yes. Praise
him again.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. What a mighty God we serve.
Amen.
How good he is. What power there is that comes from him.
Well, I get real happy. There's some things makes me happy, like Brother Dale stopped by the truck door. Brother Dale, back there, he got around, and I was talking to a couple of people, and I needed a refreshing smell. I needed a refreshing something to happen to me, and I've been standing on that pavement for quite a while there. Brother Dale got out of his truck, and he handed me some silvery wrapped up packages, and I caught the aroma. I didn't have a revival like I do when the Holy Ghost touched me, but I had a food revival. I don't know, have you ever had a food revival? The smell of that food, Lord, how it changes you. And I smelled mullet. Smoked mullet. Oh, I'm the son of a fisherman. They grew me up on mullet. I came up on mullet, fresh out of the water, smoked, fried. And when I smelled that for the deal, and he said, take more than one package. And hope you didn't give them all away to me, but it's all right if you did. Praise the name of the Lord. I took those mullet. He had put barbecue sauce on them. And then had them nice and warm. Oh my goodness, Lord, let me get back to the word. Praise him. I'm in a mullet drink. Anyhow, that God is good, isn't he?
He's good.
I said, God is good. He's an awesome God. Amen. Brother, when the day star arises in your soul, your spiritual senses take off. And you find the heart of Jesus. You feel the pulsating power of his miracle and his love. And his forgiveness. And when you write that book, you feel that. When you pray, you feel it. When you're in trouble, you feel that. When you're down, and when you get gloomy and sad, if you'll just turn and look for the day star, it's shining. He's there. All you need to do is let you become a star. And you shine. And be one of God's stars in his story. Praise the name. Lord, so the prophet said that the day star would arise. Now, leave Numbers and go to the book of Daniel. And that is the book of Psalms, pardon me, on your way to Daniel. We'll get Daniel next and we'll close with Daniel. But in the 19th Psalm, here is the precious word on the day star again. Verse 1, Psalms 19. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament showeth his handiwork. Day unto day utter speech, and night unto night showeth knowledge. There is no speech nor language where their voice is not heard. The heavens declare the glory of God. What's in the heavens? Stars are in the heavens. The creation of God. Stars. The luminous light. What's in the church? There should be stars in the church. Because this is second heaven. This is not third heaven. This is not the heaven of heavens we're going to. But we're made to sit together in heavenly places. In Christ Jesus. I considered a heavenly place. I get here and sit down. I get on my feet and I sing. I walk back and forth for 2 or 2.5 hours, sometimes 3. We're in here and we're praising God. We're praying for the sick. We're loving people. We're seeing some come to God. And sometimes the songs pick us up. Someone gets a song. Someone has a tongue, a gift of tongues. And someone interprets it. Someone gets a prophecy. It's heavenly. Nothing like it in the world. There isn't anything like God's church when it's in operation.
Amen.
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 When God's word is going forth, It's more powerful than a thousand Mississippi rivers running at one time. When the Lord is doing a miracle, Disney World, with its fantasy, can't approach it. Praise our God.
Amen.
David Copperfield is a little whiff walking around on the earth compared with his so-called magic, making bridges disappear and buildings appear. But God doesn't deal in fantasy. He deals in reality.
Yes.
When the cripple walks, the cripple walks. And the blind sees it. The blind sees it. Amen. Come on, praise our God.
Amen.
When a person is saved, they're saved.
Yes.
When a no good gambler is saved, God saves a no good gambler. The prostitute turns away from her prostitution and her ways. It's really real.
Yes.
Copperfield can't pull that off.
No.
Nobody else can. Houdini couldn't have. God doesn't do fantasy. He does reality.
Yes.
Have a show on television, only I don't see it. I don't look at it. Reality show, I hear about it. But that's nothing. That isn't nothing. You talk to God when you get a hold of God, when you call on God. Just like here tonight, the saints have called on God, and you're going home with a miracle. I believe there are miracles leaving this house tonight.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. I believe in the name of Jesus is sanctified by the Holy Ghost, old-time Pentecostal power from God. There are miracles going out of this place tonight. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'll get you up on this plane in a minute where I am. I believe that. Praise our God. Do you believe there are at least 3, 4, 5 miracles, at least of faith that are going out of this place tonight?
Yes.
Do you believe that?
Yes, sir.
Praise our God. Say amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Praise the Lord. You believe the day star has arisen here. You believe we're seeing the day star arise. Amen. 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 Praise our God. The heavens declare the glory of God. And the firmament showeth his handiwork. Now let's go to Daniel. The book of Daniel. Praise God. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Daniel, the 12th chapter of Daniel. And here the stars again appear. I'm sure glad this day is not a dark night with no stars.
Amen.
I'm glad we're here with some stars.
Amen.
There's some stars here of God.
Yes.
Praise your glorified God, the heavens.
Yes.
Are here to declare his glory tonight.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. The heavens are here to declare his glory. And this church is his firmament. We're not a little beat wimp church on 7th Avenue. We are a church that has miracles and signs and wonders. You know, I can't help it. The Holy Ghost tells me to do it. I don't know. I'd like to tell anybody and everybody that wants to keep criticizing the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, if they can do better, let them go and do better. But the Church of Jesus Christ is still Church of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. I said the Church of Jesus Christ is still the Church of Jesus Christ. And the devil has never equaled one miracle that God has done. Praise the name of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I'm about to get excited up here. Maybe praise God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Glory to God. Well, praise God, I feel something really on the comment line right now. I feel the Holy Ghost moving. I feel God's Spirit believe the power of God is present.
Yes.
Joy of the Lord is here.
Yes.
I'm so glad to be alive tonight. I'm really glad to be alive.
Yes.
I'm really glad to be pleasing God.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. We have so many challenges out there.
Yes.
Have so many pleasing
God.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Verse 3, chapter 12. And they that be wise shall shine. I'm in Daniel. Chapter 12, verse 3. And they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament. Firmament means the heavenly place. Firmament is the heavenly place. And that's what we're in tonight. And they that turn many to righteousness as the stars. If you turn anybody to righteousness, you're a star shining in the heavens, in God's firmament. Praise the name of the Lord. Someone said, Brother Morrow, I'm not anybody. I hear people that I'm not anything, I'm not nothing. Quit saying that. You are something. You're a star. If you're turning people to righteousness, if you're shining in the firmament, if you're walking and talking with Jesus, if you love Him, if you believe He's coming again, if you're helping keep the church, if you're praying, if you're walking with God, if you love God, if you're cleaning your life up, if you're sanctifying yourself, if you're living above sin, God sees you not as a low-down piece of trash in the garbage of life. You are a star.
Amen.
Shining in the heavens for the glory of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Tell the devil I said that. You put an A plus. But praise the name of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Oh, praise God. And they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. Praise God. All right. May the Lord bless you real good.
Yes.
May the Lord pray you real good. May the Lord lift you up real good. May there find nothing but goodness in your life as you go on into the coming year. Amen, 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 amen. Praise God. Yes, I'm listening.
Can you read Revelation
22:16? Well, I can. Yes, I can. Praise God.
Revelation
2:28. All right, I can read Revelation 2:28. Praise God. I'll just keep reading as long as you keep. Yeah, it is inspired. Amen. Somebody's listening. Praise the name of the Lord. Somebody's listening. Thank God. And a lot of you are listening. I know that. Many of you are listening. All of you are listening. I'm sure. Praise God. Oh, my. Look, look. Why can't I be a star? Why cannot I be one of the
morning star
with a morning star? Why cannot I be in the heavens with a morning star? Heavenly place with Christ tonight. The overcomer. The overcomer. What is an overcomer? It's one that comes over. Every problem, every difficulty, every human instance, every human moment, every human experience comes over it. Rises above it. Is a conqueror. Yeah, more than a conqueror. More than a conqueror. I don't know how true this is. I think it's one of those stories that ministers preach, but if it is true, then praise God, it serves. Because one was said, and when Muhammad Ali fought Joe Frazier, Smoking Joe, in the tour of Manila, they called it.
Yeah.
That when he got home, slumped on the bed, the people have been saying you're the conqueror of all men in the ring, boxing. And he said, no, I just gave all the money I have in the hands of my managers and my wife. They are more than conquerors. However true that is true, however that is. I'm more than a conqueror because Christ doesn't just make me a conqueror. I'm more than conqueror. Because I'm in a heavenly place with Christ as a star, twinkling in the darkness of the world. And here he said, and he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I have received of my Father, and I will give him the morning star. Thank you, Jesus, for the morning star. You're the bright and morning star. And Revelation, what was it? 22:16. Praise our God. Praise our God. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the root and offspring of David, and the bright and morning star. That clinches it, doesn't it? That clinches it. Right and the morning star. All right? Woo. That's your right and morning star. Take peace with Christmas season. I don't want to do all the problems. I be out there lurking in the shadows, but they will come. Because God is going to defend you, protect you, watch over you. Let Jesus give you hope, and light, and joy, and peace, and get ready. Get ready for the most tremendous year he's ever given you. You're going to live, you're going to be blessed, you're going to enjoy it, you're going to do God's will. Praise the name of the Lord. And you may be saved. If you're unsaved tonight, hearing this message, the bright and morning star can come to your life as you start this year out. If you need complete healing in Christ, I believe we touch the hem of his garment tonight. Praise our God. I believe the church is alive and well. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Let me bring my name up here. And I will sit back and we will sing a song of praise. Or someone may have a word when I draw back here. Add to the night. It's young yet. It isn't completely finished. And God can give us whatever he wants to give us. Praise the name of the Lord. Is this a bad call? Asked if we would pray for a little boy called Bear. Sounds cute, doesn't he? Little Bear. He's not quite 1 year old. And has to undergo surgery on the 28th. He's a friend of Nina's from the Word of Charlotte Assembly. All right. We'll pray for Bear tonight. Little boy, not quite 1 year old. Having surgery on the 28th. Praise the name of the Lord. And then on the dining room, that is all those working in the dining room, you can look at the list up here on the bulletin board and see your names there. I see Brother Evans, is that Brother Evans? Brother Lochar, Kenny, Sister Yvonne Hoffhouse, Brother Glenn, the story and the martyrs, right? Pardon me? These all came in this year. This is the list that came in. They're not working in the dining room. All right. I got down here working in the dining room. I see. Take a great big smile for me. Sister Mara wrote me this, and I decided it now with her help. She wrote two notes here. These all came into the church this last year. The Vince family, Brother Lochar, Kate, Yvonne House came back to the assembly. Brother Glenn, Brother Shorey, the Marlers. These all came in this last year, plus others, of course, the Lord mentioned. And the Warren down there, yes, our evangelist. Now, what I read below that, and I hope you now can take a sigh of relief over it. Those that are working in the living room, whoever you are, look at the bulletin board and find out between now and tomorrow who's working in the dining room. You that I read the names of, forget it for the moment. Amen. We have the mail straightened out. All right, haven't we had a good night in the Lord? Have we had, you know, is there anybody that had a song, a praise, testimony, they have tonight?
I talked to my sister, and I have never heard her sound so much better than what she has. And as mother, she was out in a parking lot, and she was jumping and skipping and just having a ball, going Christmas shopping, but she was okay. And Brian, bless his heart, he can talk better. His lung infection is getting cured. The doctor said there was no sign of cancer, so he's on his mend. But we need to pray for these kids today where the smoking is a crutch. It's, I can't get him to quit. I wish I could. But
pray for their salvation.
I have to know that he's going to be all right.
Pray for their salvation.
I've had good reports on both of them, so they're doing well.
Praise God. Brother John, would you think, you know, would you touch me? Would you come and say, I just felt a little bit of a
praise God.
Let me catch you for the word given tonight. He touched me. The morning star, bright and the morning star, the day star, let him touch you, stars of God. Here tonight. Praise God, you touched me. Oh, but you touch me. You can look, yes. Pray God, you can rise up in this. We're going to sing this, and we're going to stand with Brother John as he sings, and we'll pick it up in the course as he sings it. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Shaku pai hai burden, leader Lord of us in shame. Thank you.
for the night of rest. Send us back tomorrow.
Yes.
With our hands lifted up, our hearts lifted up. A great day in the Lord. As we near the time they say was your birth, let us sing it throughout the week. He indeed was born. He indeed is alive. He indeed has risen and is coming back again. And everybody said, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord and praise the Lord. Get your